Good morning, students. As all of you know that I am your science teacher, Kenneth Irfan, and I will teach you in class prep 3, as usual, the science. But we are going to start physics in this class. See the book, Physics, a course of O-level, second edition. So, the first chapter which we are going to start is, the name of the chapter is Unit 1, Measurement of Physical Quantities. As it is written in the board, Unit number 1, Measurement of Physical Quantities. When we talk about the measurement, so first of all, it is very necessary that we should know, we should understand what is measurement. When we go in any shop, for example, in the grocery shop or to purchase the cloths, so in grocery shop, when we say anything, when we want to buy anything, he just measure and then give it to us. And for example, if you want to take the cloth, it is measured with the meter rod and then it is given to us. So everything which we want to buy, first it is measured and then it is given to us. So this is the meaning, that this is the meaning of measurement. And the second word of this unit is measurement of physical quantities. So what are physical quantities? Physical quantities are the quantities which can be measured. Whether the things are smaller, whether the things are larger or greater, but if they can be measured, it means they are measurable quantities. So these are physical quantities. Which can be measured, these are called physical quantities. So, the first, as I have told you, that we are going to start physics. Do you know what is physics? Before starting the chapter, I just want to tell you what is physics. As it is written on the board, physics. What is physics? Physics. Physics is the branch of science which deals with the nature and property, which deals with the nature and property and matter and energy. So, what is physics? Physics is the branch of science which deals with the properties of matter and energy. So, first of all, we should know what is matter. If we are going to start physics, and the physics is the branch of science which deals with the study of matter, the properties of matter and energy and their relationship, so it is very necessary that we should know what is matter. As what is matter? Matter is anything which has mass and occupied space is called matter. As you have listen in the previous classes, you have read in the previous classes that what is matter? Matter is anything which has a mass and occupies space is called matter. And now we know that matter has different three states. And what are these three states of matter? Solid, liquid and gases. It means that all the things, when we see around us, for example in the room, when we see different things, these are some are in the form of solid and air is in the form of gas, and if we have a water in our water bottles, this is a liquid form. So matter is present in this universe in three states: solid, liquid and gases. And we can take if you want to understand more about the states of matter, you can take the example of water as well. Water is present in the form of liquid, but it has two other states. Solid, when we keep the water in the refrigerator, it changes into solid form in the form of ice. Ice is in the form of solid. And now if it get the temperature from the environment, it changes into water. Now if we heat more, then it changes into water vapors, and these water vapors are the gaseous state of matter. Now you have better understand about the matter. Now what is energy? The capacity to do anything is called energy. For example, if you want to pull or push the desk, we need some force to apply on the desk. If you want to pull or push, but we need force. Due to this force, the desk can be pulled or pushed. It means that this force has energy. And what is energy? Energy is capacity to do anything. And by using energy, by using force, force is the form of energy. By using the force, we can easily push and pull the desk. So this is called energy. And if we talk about the forms of energy, there are a lot of forms of energy. For example, potential energy, kinetic energy, thermal energy, electrical energy, chemical energy, nuclear energy, heat energy, light energy, sound energy. There are a lot of forms of energy. One more thing about energy, just keep remember that energy can never be produced nor be destroyed. It is a fundamental fact that energy can never be produced nor be destroyed, but it changes from one form to another form. So how we can understand that energy can never be produced nor be destroyed? Let's have an example. For example, if we take the example of sun. Sun is the main source of energy, which is producing constantly the heat and light energy. But the question arises that sun is producing heat and light energy. It means there is something which is producing light and energy, light and heat. But if you know that how the sun is producing energy, sun is producing energy by the burning gases. And these gases are present in the universe. So these gases are producing present in the universe. By burning these gases, sun is producing light and heat energy. When this light and heat energy reaches to the ground, this energy is trapped by the plants, and plants produce food. You know very well that plants take energy from the sun and produce food. This food is utilized by the plant, and these plants also store energy in its different parts, like leaves, like flowers, like fruits, like stem, like roots. And you know that coal is produced by the plant. Now the energy which is trapped by the sun, which is trapped from the sun by the plants, now this energy is stored in the form of coal. When this coal is burned, for example, the coal is burned, and it boils the water in different boilers. For example, this heat energy is now transferred into water. This water is boiling and produces gases, and these gases turns the turbine, and by turning on the turbine, they are producing light and heat energy. Same is the process in the generators. So one form is changes into other form. Now the energy which is produced by the sun now is changes into electrical energy. Okay, so the energy only changes its form. It changes from one form to another, but it can never be destroyed. It remains present in the environment. Okay, so now we are going to start the first topic, which is the physical quantities and SI units. These all things we have already discussed. But here in the first paragraph, this is all about the study of physics and its branches. The branches of physics are general physics, thermal physics, waves, which includes light and sound, electricity, and magnetism, and atomic physics. These are the main five branches which are written in the first paragraph. And in the second paragraph, I'm not going to read it for you because you will read it by yourself. Read these two topics very carefully, and then you will understand the whole thing. So, in the second paragraph, it is told that from where the knowledge of physics came. It is all about the efforts of different scientists. They work on the matter and energy, and the relationship of matter with the energy, and the relationship of energy with the matter, and they form the theories. Now, we check these theories by doing different experiments. But one thing which is very necessary is the measurement. When we are going to do any experiment, it is very necessary that measurement should be accurate. When there will be accurate measurement, every time the results will be same. But if the measurement is not accurate, so then there are a chances of error. So while doing experiment, it is very necessary that the measurement should be accurate. In the third paragraph, there are some basic quantities and derived quantities. Let's come about the basic quantities and the derived quantities. These are some basic quantities: length, mass, time, electric current, temperature, and two more quantities are given in your book: luminous intensity and the amount of substance. But these two, luminous intensity and amount of substance, we will not cover in this book. We will cover only these five basic quantities: length, mass, time, electric current, and temperature. So the basic physical quantities are these five. And first one, length, its basic unit is meter. Length is measured in meters, and its symbol is smaller m. The second one is mass. Mass is measured in kilograms, and its symbol is kg. Time is measured in seconds, s for seconds. And electric current, is the basic unit of electric current is ampere, and A is its symbol. Temperature. Temperature is, the basic unit of temperature is Kelvin, and K is the symbol of this one. So these are the basic physical quantities. But if we want to talk about the derived quantities, what is the difference between the basic quantities and derived quantities? These are basic quantities, they are independent. They don't depend on any other. But what are derived quantities? These are basic quantities and derived. Derived quantities depend on these basic quantities. If we want to get any derived quantity, we definitely use these basic quantities, and then we get the derived quantity. For example, if we talk about the speed, speed is the derived quantity. This is not the basic quantity because it depends on the length and time. Length and time means the distance covered that will be taken in the as a meter, and in how much time we have covered the distance, that will be taken in the second. So the speed we can get the speed of anything by distance covered. Upon time taken. So, distance, we will use length to measure the distance and we will use time to measure the time. So, this quantity speed depends on distance and time. Speed is derived quantity and distance and time are the basic or fundamental quantities. So, what is derived quantity? Derived quantities are the quantities which depend on the basic or fundamental quantities. Now, see, this is a flow chart which will be given to you as a homework as well. So, see, physics, as we have discussed, that physics is the study of matter and energy. When we study the matter, we study the matter in two ways. Means, first of all, we will see the properties of the matter and then we will study its relationship with the energy. First, properties, and the second way is relationship with the energy. Likewise, the properties of energy will be studied and then the relationship with the matter. Relationship of energy with the matter. And when these two relationship, these two relationship makes the different branches of physics. Number one is general physics. This general physics includes exchange of energy, force, basic concepts of time and speed. In the thermal physics, as by its name, thermal. Thermal means heat. So this, the branch of physics which deals with the study of heat, that is called thermal physics. Waves, there are two types of waves, that can be light waves, that can be sound waves. These sound waves and light waves are studied under the branch of physics, that is called waves. And electricity and magnetism. Electricity, we know very well, and magnetism, that includes the properties of magnet and its working and its applications. That the last one is atomic physics. Atomic physics deals with the study of atoms and its properties, its functions, its applications. So this is and in the, see this book, page number 2, all this flowchart is given, and on the next page, basic physical quantities, name of basic unit and symbol of unit, these are given. There are 7 basic quantities, but we will study only 5 in this book. So here the first topic which is topic 1.1, going to